Would you like to potentially grow your international audience on YouTube? If you could simply and easily add captions for other languages, then it's possible you could increase the view time of a viewer who doesn't speak your language. Now, normally I do cooking videos. Warning, there is no cooking in this video. But please do subscribe if you like healthy cooking mixed with dad jokes and puns. But here I wanted to get a step-by-step visual out on how to do this because YouTube sent an email to creators on May 11th, 2021, saying there was new functionality for adding foreign language subtitles. It's always been available as an option, but I think you could only upload text files that were already in another language. Honestly, I don't know because I looked at it once and I couldn't figure it out, so I promptly gave up. But now you can add them from the second screen of the video upload page. Honestly, I couldn't figure that step out either, but I did figure out a very easy way, which I will show you step by step what to do to click on to achieve this. Once you do it a couple times, you'll get the hang of it and can add as many languages as you like to any of your videos that have voice. So without further ado, let's begin. Note that this tutorial is for videos where you have voice, where YouTube then uses its speech-to-text feature to create subtitles in the speaker's language. This tutorial is not for videos with no voice, and also, it will not translate a text box you have added to your video on screen during editing. Now, in order for this to work, when you first upload your video, you have to have a language for the video chosen on the first page of the upload screen. On this first screen, go to Show More, then scroll down to the language selection. Now, on the second screen, you'll see an option to add captions. But as far as I can tell, this is only for the language of the video. And there's an easier way, so I'm going to skip this for now. Then you can publish your video or set it to publish at a certain date and time. Either way, the next steps are the same. However, there is a benefit to setting it for a future date and time. Even if you make your future date and time 30 minutes after you add your subtitles, this will allow your video to have the subtitles for the very first view. For the next step, you can either go to Subtitles on the left-hand side or select the video you want under Content. I'm going to do it from the Content submenu. The steps will be the same whether this is an old video or something you schedule to publish in the future. Now, I'm going to scroll down to a video I know I need to add subtitles to. Then I hit the Details pencil icon. This brings me to the screen for that video. Now, look on the left side of the screen and click on Subtitles. Now you'll see the language you published the video in my case, English, and then there's this great chart showing what languages the viewers of my channel speak. I get this as one of the many great features of my TubeBuddy subscription. With this information, you could choose to focus on just a few key languages or go all out and put in as many as you want. And this is just one of the many great features from TubeBuddy. The main thing I use it for is keyword research, and it's super great for that. If you want a free month of TubeBuddy to try it out, just use my personal referral link in the description below. If you sign up for a paid subscription, I'll get a small commission to help support my channel at no extra cost to you. I say it's a free month. Try it out. See how helpful it can be. So next, you're going to go to the upper right and click on Duplicate and Edit. It'll ask you if you want to overwrite track, hit confirm. This will bring up a screen with the YouTube transcription. Next, you're going to hit the link that says edit timings. And this is pretty cool because what you see next is YouTube has broken out the timings with the appropriate text automatically. This is an unbelievable time saver. Now, if you've ever seen some of YouTube's subtitle speech to text guesses, they can be pretty hilarious. So, this may not be 100% accurate, and if you have time, you probably should check it over. But for most of us who don't have time or need to worry about perfection, just take a chance and hope it'll be mostly correct. When all looks good, go back up to the top right and hit Publish. Now we're ready to add our additional languages. Can you guess where that might be? Yes, you've got it, the Add Language button. From there, the list of languages comes up, and I'm going to my channel's viewer's second most spoken language, Hindi. Interesting aside, when I was scrolling through, I even saw an option for Klingon. Now that would be really interesting if it works.
Ha Anglo meskul, robaka, de bui, jonajaj, guibla tolo, cha, uku.
Next, if you have one of the higher tier subscriptions to TubeBuddy, they include a feature that translates titles. I don't have that feature, so I'm going to skip it. So I'm going to go to Add under Subtitles column. Now, there's all these options here, but you guessed it. The easiest one, if you're not worried about total accuracy, Auto Translate. I'm presuming it uses Google Translate as the engine to translate captions and magically and instantly do this for you. Pretty cool, eh? You can now see my words in Hindi. Now, if I knew Hindi, I could further edit this manually, but I don't, so I won't. Last, just go back up to the top and hit publish, and you're done. Keep adding languages with this same process if you like. Now, let's check it out in action. I'm going back to the content page, find the video I want, then I'm clicking on View on YouTube. Ugh, ads on my channel, and I'm not even monetized. Maybe someday. If every single one of you watches my channel for around 100 hours each, I might get close. Oh, and I still need a lot more subscribers to get to 1,000, so please do subscribe. You can see on the right, TubeBuddy populates my screen with the current stats from the video, which is another nice feature. Now, most of you probably know, but for those of you who do not, in order to turn on subtitles from a computer, you must go down to the Settings gear icon, go to Subtitles CC, and then pick the language from you want from the drop-down list. I'll select Hindi so we can see it on the screen. And there it is. The location is slightly different on mobile. You hit the three dots in the upper right, then select captions, then choose from the list of available languages. Now, if you're adding a lot of languages, you might start to wonder, is this worth all the time and effort I will put in for any potential added view time I might get? Well, this isn't view time, but here's one stat you can look at that will tell if it's being used. Let's go to the analytics page and click on audience. Scroll down past the countries selection and you'll see the top subtitle CC languages. From here you can see the number of views by subtitle language. And you can see the same information in the stats for a single video. Now, just like any experiment when you're creating in YouTube, you can evaluate after a while if it's worth your time and effort to continue. Which brings me to my final point. Because not many creators use subtitles, viewers will not often bother to turn them on. I know I don't, or they just don't know about it. So, if you don't remind people at the beginning to turn on closed captioning, then you risk them not knowing you even did all the hard work to add them. And they maybe leave your video a lot sooner than they would have if they knew about the subtitles. So I would recommend adding a message at the beginning of your video reminding folks to turn them on. There you have it. I hope this tutorial was useful. All the steps are listed in the description below. And if you like healthy cooking sprinkled with dad jokes and puns, please do subscribe to my channel. If you don't, that's okay, but please still give me a like and a comment and share it with other creators. Thanks for watching.